Hello, everyone. It's great to be back here in Thunder Bay. But before I start on anything else, I want us to all give a huge whooping round of applause for our graduating students. Congratulations, guys. Woo. This is a milestone achievement, and I'm pleased to have a chance to be with you on this special day. I want to thank Elder Jean and thank everyone for welcoming us onto Fort William First Nation Traditional Territory. I also want to thank Terry Varga and Ted Pippin for a warm welcome, and a few of the colleagues are here today. We've got Minister Haidu, MPs Don Rusnak and Bob Nault, and it's great to see you all. It's great to thank you in person in front of everyone for the amazing work you all do to fight for your communities in Ottawa. Now, it's no secret that the nature of work is changing. The people in this room know that better than most. Technology has transformed not only how we work, but also what we need to learn. These big shifts have created a lot of uncertainty and pressure for Canadians, young and old. I can't tell you how many times I've heard students tell me that they can't get a job because they don't have work experience, and they can't get work experience because they don't have a job. Or experienced workers who worry that they didn't have the right skills to get a good, well-paying job in the new economy. What became increasingly clear to us is that Canadians often felt like they lacked the resources or opportunities to take their careers to the next level. These are challenges you may have wrestled with when you were thinking about signing up for more training. Notre gouvernement a donc décidé de passer à l'action et d'investir des sommes historiques dans la formation des compétences. Nous avons tout d'abord bonifié le programme Subventions et prêts études canadiens pour aider les étudiants des familles à revenus faibles et moyens à payer leurs études postsecondaires. Et pour aider ceux qui sont déjà sur le marché du travail à mettre leurs compétences à niveau, on a apporté une première vague de changement à l'assurance emploi en 2017. Les travailleurs sans emploi qui souhaiteraient suivre une formation ou acquérir des nouvelles connaissances peuvent maintenant retourner aux études sans perdre leurs prestations d'assurance emploi. Ça fait une énorme différence pour les parents qui comptent sur ces prestations pour subvenir aux besoins de leur famille. C'est le genre de mesure qui fait une vraie différence dans la vie des gens, qui permet aux familles de planifier leur avenir et celui de leurs enfants. That said, there's much more to be done. So with Budget 2019, we're renewing our focus on skills training and launching more initiatives to get Canadians the help they need to succeed. To make skills training more accessible, we're launching the new Canada Training Benefit, which includes two key components. The first is the Canada Training Credit. Each year, workers earning between $10,000 and $150,000 will receive a $250 tax credit to upgrade their skills, which they can accumulate over time. That means that for 4 weeks every 4 years, Canadians will have $1,000 to help cover training fees. The Construction Craft Worker Program is a great example of the kind of training program we want to see more Canadians enroll in. The second component is the EI Training Support Benefit. Workers will receive EI benefits for up to 4 weeks while they take time off work to upgrade their skills. At the same time, we're also laying the groundwork to ensure that every young Canadian who wants a work-integrated learning opportunity can get one within 10 years. And to make repaying loans for post-secondary education more affordable, we're lowering the interest rate of Canada student loans and apprentice loans and introducing a six-month interest-free grace period for recent graduates. These changes should help students transition to the labour market more easily and save up to $2,000 over the lifetime of their loan. We're also developing a new strategy to support apprentices and those employed in the skilled trades and launching a national campaign to encourage young people to choose a career in the trades. Taken together, these measures will help people get the right training and support they need to succeed in the job market. Right now, middle-class Canadians who are already having a hard time making ends meet are struggling to put money aside for training. Well, we want to take some of that pressure off and help them advance their career on their own terms. Canadians have the right skills to take on the jobs of tomorrow, so that's crucial that we keep them that way so we can keep our economy strong and growing and the middle class thriving. And that's why our government will continue to invest in Canadians and in their future.